spoiled brat. Brad was the most spoiled boy in the world. He came from a super rich family who had made their money from having money. Brad lived with his mom and pop in a 100-bedroomed mansion in America. Because Brad was so spoiled, he didn't even take care of the amazing things he was given. His mom and pop bought their only child all he ever dreamed of and more. 101 puppies that Brad quickly tired of and put in the trash. His own miniature white limousine that Brad deliberately crashed into a wall at speed, smashing it to pieces. A robot that Brad's mom and pop bought their son to keep him company as he didn't have any friends. Somehow, Brad managed to fall out with the robot, and he pushed it into the swimming pool. It lay at the bottom, rusting away. A ball-serving machine that was meant to help Brad with his tennis lessons. Instead, the boy turned it on his long-suffering tennis coach, firing balls straight at him as if it was a cannon. Ouch! A complete set of leather-bound encyclopedias. He read the entry for Aardvark and then gave up and used the rest of the pages as toilet roll. Rip. Wipe. A priceless old oil painting that Brad smashed his head through so he could use it as a Halloween costume. Smash. A cut glass chandelier for his bedroom that he used to swing on. Swing. An antique double bass that Brad had never once played. Instead, when the snow came, the boy sat on the instrument to use it as a toboggan. Whiz! One morning, Brad swept down the family mansion's long staircase in his silk pajamas, dressing gown, and monogrammed velvet slippers.
Good morning, Brad Jr.,
murmured his parents. Pop was checking his stocks and shares in the Financial Times. Meanwhile, Mom was reading a glossy magazine and taking some pleasure in pictures of the rich and famous who'd had plastic surgery that had gone horribly wrong. As usual, they were being waited on by their rather snooty English butler, Hopkins.
Pancakes, butler!
Demanded the boy as he entered the grand dining room and walked over to the impossibly long table.
With cream, ice cream, and chocolate sauce, now!
Yes, of course, young sir,
purred Hopkins, before bowing and retreating to the kitchen. Brad Jr. slumped down at his usual place at the head of the table.
Mom? Pop?
Yes, Bradley Jr., did you enjoy your $1 million birthday party yesterday? Asked Pop.
It was so-so, the boy replied. I've been thinking.
Oh, yes?
Prompted Mom.
It wasn't often her son thought.
It's not fair that I have to wait another whole year for my birthday.
Well, everyone has to wait, Bradley Jr., said Pop. That's why birthdays are special.
I don't want to wait, declared the boy. I want it to be my birthday every day.
Mom and Pop shed a look. They were used to their son acting like a spoiled brat, but this was a new low.
Son, yesterday we laid on an incredibly expensive day for you,
began Mom.
You had a giant chocolate cake.
I love cake, announced Brad.
We know, said Pop.
There was a funfair in the garden, a mountain of presents,
continued Mom.
And we bussed in hundreds of children from all over the state to pretend to be your friends, added Pop.
Then you can do the same again today, and the next day, and the day after that. Where are my pancakes, butter? And the day after that, and the day after that.
And if we don't?
Asked Mom. Brad Jr. thought for a moment.
If you don't, I will put you both in an old folks' home at the earliest opportunity and leave you there to rot.
Pop sighed.
better get going, he said.
Yes, exclaimed Brad. Pancakes now!
Hopkins emerged from the kitchen, carrying a silver platter.
Your pancakes, sir,
the butler announced.
That was too slow, hissed Brad. Pop, can you have him flogged?
Oh, that would be wrong, son.
Shame, mused the boy.
Hopkins raised an eyebrow. Hastily, preparations were made, and at 4 o'clock on the dot, Brad's second birthday party in 2 days was in full swing. There was a huge disco tent on the lawn, a dolphin show in the swimming pool, and a bouncy castle as big as the family mansion itself. Though Brad decided, as it was his birthday, only he could bounce on it.
Happy birthday!
Cried Mom and Pop as a giant chocolate cake was wheeled out.
Cake! Yelled the boy. Happy birthday to me!
With his hands, Brad scooped himself a humongous piece of cake and stuffed it in his mouth.
Where are my presents?
He demanded, spraying crumbs all over the busting guests, who looked a little bored as they had all been at his party yesterday. Hopkins staggered along, holding a mountain of presents.
Not enough, said the boy. Tomorrow, I want more.
The butler shook his head, and the presents tumbled to the ground. Mom and Pop looked at each other and sighed. The next day, it was the same story. Brad had yet another birthday party. This time, there was a roller coaster on the lawn. An elephant to ride on. And a famous pop star singing his hits on a little stage. Brad decided that everyone else at the party had to wear headphones, so only he could hear the performance. Once again, the biggest birthday cake anyone had ever seen was wheeled in by 4 servants.
Cake! Exclaimed the boy. Happy birthday to me!
What?
Said Mom. She couldn't hear what her son had said because she still had her headphones on. The boy shouted this time.
I said happy birthday to me!
Oh, right, yes. A happy birthday, Bradley Jr.,
said the lady. Today, the cake was the size of a paddling pool. With both hands, Brad scooped up as much of it as he possibly could and stuffed it in his face. The slice was, in fact, so big that what he left behind was smaller than what he took.